freedom in our country. I am also here now as the head of news when I see press freedom actually starting to be curtailed. So there are many different things. Is it to your advantage to not know what is going on around you? Which is essentially what that point you were making says. It says that we should take one agenda, which they did in Singapore, by the way. Lee Kuan Yew basically controlled the media, all for a developmental goal. But until now, even though in the last 42 years, Singapore has moved to become a first world nation, they're still struggling with how to make their people more creative. They're still struggling with how to encourage independent thought. This is something that we grapple with as a society. So freedom of speech is one of the rights guaranteed in the Constitution. As you know, 12 of our journalists were arrested last November 29th at the peninsula because we believe that you had the right to know what was going on inside the peninsula. It's a tricky topic because the police will say it goes against its obstruction of justice. We say you need to know because what if the police came in there and just shot everybody? Are you willing to take an invested interest view rather than have an observer to watch it, okay? The other one, the corollary to that question was, what do we do with sister companies? It's not a new question. CNN is had many sister companies. AOL, Time Warner owns CNN. What's the answer to that? It's called professional journalism. Just because we are sister companies doesn't mean that we take each other's vested interests. In fact, if you know within ABS-CBN itself, the news does not champion the vested interests of ABS-CBN because we are supposed to champion the people's interests. So even in a situation like the Ultra, the news took a very, essentially our reporters came to me that day and said, you know, are we going to put on air these things? I said, you take the worst criticism against ABS-CBN and you put it on air. And then you give ABS-CBN the chance to respond. Third question, should we take student works? Yes, we can. But oftentimes, I'd love you to train with us so that your work can become more sophisticated. Right off the top, where we take student works right away is in a program called Square Off on AMC. We want to encourage you to be honest, to debate, to speak up for your ideas. That's what Square Off does. I think the last one for news. There are two more questions for news. One is the educational TV is gone, anime. I just want to challenge your notion about the idea that conventional media is bad. That's the implicit assumption in the way you ask the question. That now, anime is bad for you. Anime is actually pretty good because it's a coming of age story every time and it pushes children. If you look at why it's integral to Japanese society and why our children now are watching it, they're actually looking for heroic figures. That's what animes give them. Another thing is off the top. Entertainment, dramas, comedies have actually grown more complex in the last four decades. More complex meaning your brains, you are actually learning as you're watching without knowing it. I call it a gym for your brain. How do you peg this? IQ. IQ is spatial learning. It's the same reason, it's the same types of facilities you use when you're playing video games. It's a different type of learning, but there is collateral learning in it. And in the developed world, they've proven that IQs have actually increased three times over the last two decades. That's kind of interesting to me. Finally, the last one of the news, the three-year-old boy. ABS-CBN has a 116-page standards and ethics manual. In that, there are guidelines. If you notice, we don't show dead bodies, we don't show blood, we don't show... We've actually set in place these guidelines, but if you find everyone's sensibilities are different, right? If you find that it's upsetting to you, please write us and tell us about it. Our standards and ethics manual change, but in general, we are a reflection of the society we serve. I know that from 2005 until now, we've pulled back the blood and gore from our newscasts because we feel that the challenge should be in engaging you in the stories not in blood and gore. That's it. The power for a living word.